Federal Reserve is going to buy $105 billion more dollars in treasuries. The U.S. Deficit Commission is recommending that Social Security increases retirement age. And Moscow is going to build 5,000 more underground bunkers by the end of 2012. Hey guys, it's November 11th, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcat. First, the Federal Reserve is going to buy $105 billion in treasuries next month. Well, over the next month. They're going to try to reinvest $250 to $300 billion in proceeds from their mortgage-backed debt and agency securities and try to put them into treasuries. Basically, this is the snake eating its own tail. It's completely unsustainable, and I think more and more people are catching on. Now, China's SAIC is close to making a deal with GM. They're going to try to get an IPO stake in GM. This of course, is going to have the approval from the Chinese government. There's just no way this is actually going to go through without approval from the Chinese government. It's kind of strange. I mean, I keep reading it. I can't believe it. No, they're basically government-funded automakers. GM is basically, it's not just General Motors, it's kind of like Government Motors. They both get support from the government. And even when they don't, it's just a matter of time until they get more support from the government. And it looks like they're being pretty close to finalizing this deal. And it looks like they can actually have a stake in GM. China Motors? I mean, what the heck? Am I even reading this correctly? It's unimaginable. It's U.S. Debt Commission recommends changes to Social Security. Now, a draft proposal suggests that it'll be a good idea to cut Social Security benefits. I always thought it was a system that wasn't sustainable, and I thought it was something that was used by the government just to bring in more revenue, and they didn't really even manage the money properly. But anyway, it always seemed more like a Ponzi scheme, but what do I know? They're going to try to raise the retirement age from 27 to 28, do that by 2050, as if the system is going to last that long. And then they're going to try to raise it to 69 by 2075. There's going to be a hardship exception, but I mean, seriously, I mean, they're going to make some changes a lot sooner, but by 2050. They said by 2050 to make it seem like it's going to be like 40 years from now. Yeah, right. Newark Airport screener accused of stealing electronics from baggage. Apparently, he became so ambitious that he allegedly tried to steal a $47,000 camera from an HBO crew and a camcorder from a CNN employee. Unbelievable. Meanwhile, there's reports of abuse in regards to this airport policy and the full body scanners. Basically, the idea is that you have to subject yourself to a full body scanner. They can see all of your body. They can basically see you naked, your private parts, and all of that. And if you don't go along with that, and if your kids don't go along with that, then you're going to have to go through a physical pat-down. And they can use the palm of their hands to search your kids and your body. There's reports they touch the breast, they touch the groin area, the butt, whatever. They touch whatever. How humiliating, it's so humiliating that somebody would do that to another person. I mean, I'm not saying I would be a great parent, I know I wouldn't be, but there's no way in the world I would let some guy put his hands on my kid like that. I mean, what the hell? I mean, you know what kind of pervert is filling up your kid? I mean, come on. They're going to fill you up. I'm not saying that every TSA worker is going to be like that, but then again, I mean, there's a lot of them who are shady, as we found out in the story above. 1 out of 10 kids in the U.S. has ADHD. According to the CDC, Center for Disease Control and Prevention, they're saying that there's greater awareness and there's better screening, so now they're able to pick up more. It's been a 22% increase, according to this new study. They're studying children between the ages of 4 and 17. So what do you think? Do you think it's an environmental change? So here's a change right here. A surgeon actually owns up to his mistake. He did the wrong surgery. He operated on the wrong hand. He was trying to fix a trigger finger that was painful for the 65-year-old woman. But he ended up, she didn't speak the language, and there was some miscommunications. They didn't go through a formal check, and the mistake was made. You know, I would be pissed if I was her, but then, again, I appreciate the fact that this guy admit to his mistake. Dr. Ring, I think it's good that he came out and spoke about this. He issued a public apology. I just think that's great, because at least now people can learn from his mistake, and instead of just covering things up like a lot of people like to do in many industries, including the medical industries, and throughout our society here in America, it's good to acknowledge mistakes and deal with it so that other people can learn from them and we can correct those mistakes and make sure they don't happen again. Okay, oil hits a 25-month high. 25-month high. I still think it's going to be going a lot higher. I don't know if it's going to hit my $129 mark prediction for this year, but we'll see. Russia is going to build 5,000 more nuclear bomb shelters. Yes. By the end of 2012. No, well, their government is not. The government is saying it's just a precaution. It's not because of any specific reason. They only have 50% coverage. Their current shelter is only going to hold about 50% of their population. And since their metro system is often not located near the residential areas, they need some new shelters that are going to be located near the people where they live. Their infrastructure is basically lacking, so they're going to try to provide more coverage. So why do you really believe this reason? I don't believe in the whole the world's going to end in 2012 stuff. I've done a video on that, but it's interesting. It's interesting that they would go about doing it now. Oh yes, I'm going to be on Blog TV Sunday. This Sunday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. That's 5 p.m. Pacific Time. So I hope to see you guys there, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 5 p.m. Pacific Time on Blog TV. I'll put an announcement video up and also put a link in this video. Okay, there's been a lot of people trying to sabotage my Blog TV, so what I'm going to do is require that everybody who wants to comment must become a member of Blog TV. I'm not going to let guests comment, because every time I do that, people just flood the room with a bunch of nonsense. So to cut down on that, you won't have to deal with that anymore, because now we'll have moderators and nobody will be able to chat unless they are actual members of Blog TV. It's free. It's completely free. So just join. All right. Have a good day. And remember, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.